This conference will now be recorded.
All right, folks, I think we can start now. We have around 200 students joining in this session. In case you face any difficulties in audio, feel free to basically interrupt me. Somebody can basically mention that audio is not visible. And in case you have any questions, you can post those questions in the chat window, or you can directly ask the questions by using a mic. So only thing you need to make sure is that when you're talking, there is no background noise. All right. So in the last 1 week, Jaykumar had introduced, Jaykumar had taken up sessions on how to prepare resume and how to face interviews in general. I understand that all of us are quite curious about how things will turn up once the COVID-19 situation gets resolved. So hopefully things will become better in the coming days. So in terms of what we can do, students, before you can resume your normal classroom, normal classrooms, and before you face interviews, is that we can be very well prepared to face the interviews. We all know that things may not be as easy as it has been earlier because of the current situation, and we don't know how the economy is going to respond to this situation. But we can always be better equipped with good understanding of topics which you are learning, and be prepared to face interviews whenever it comes. So just to give you some updates, there are certain companies still planning to hire during this time also through video conferencing calls. So we may have some interviews lined up during this lockdown period also. So we need to make sure that we are prepared to face those interviews. All right. Okay. I'll do a mute all so that there is no more noise. So we have planned a 5-day session for this interview prep virtual conferencing sessions. So first 3 days will be focused on topics which are generic in nature. So I'll randomly pick up some topics from C programming, and we'll discuss the solutions or answers for those questions. And on the 4th and 5th day, we'll conduct a small workshop. I shared the details on how we can use function pointers to build generic functions. So we'll keep on basically having these interview prep sessions and workshops so that you are prepared and up to date. All right. So I'll share my screen now. And what I'll do is I'll share some of the questions I'm going to discuss today. So there are certain limitations in virtual classrooms, but I'll try my best to explain things in an easier way. I have shared my screen. Please check if it's visible. You can confirm in the chat window. All right.
Not visible.
Okay. Not visible. Of them seem not visible. It may take some time to load, I understand. Okay, so these are some of the questions which I have shared to some of the batches, but what I feel is that we can discuss the solution for these questions. Then for tomorrow, maybe we can have some other set of questions which will involve more topics from C. So I hope the question is visible. All right, so the first question is a very basic question, which wherein we need to give an answer. So please understand that we are discussing these questions so that when you face the interviews, you're able to answer it. So it's not about you knowing, it's about how you answer those questions. That's what really matters. So first question is, explain pass by value and pass by reference with an example. Whoever has at least completed the initial few chapter sub C should be able to answer these question. So when you say pass by value, Kiran, I'll answer your question later. You can ask questions which are relevant to the session. All right. So what is pass by value? Right. Is the question here. So we know that when you call a function, typically you pass arguments to that function, and these arguments can be accessed from within a function by declaring parameters, right? So when you use a parameter passing mechanism wherein the parameters are passed by value, right? It's called pass by reference. So a simple example could be, let's say define a function like this. So I'll open a terminal. I hope the terminal is visible. So I just wrote a simple program which illustrates what is passed by value in general. So can you tell me what will be the value of result here? Maybe in the chat window.
Five, sir, five.
All right, I'm getting a lot of answers here. All right. Okay. So plenty of answers. Okay. I hope you've seen the program. Okay. So I'm getting answers as so I know there is a semicolon here. No problem. Corrected the semicolon thing. Okay. Somebody is telling 999. Okay, so I got multiple answers. Majority answered, gave the answer as 5. Some gave the answer as 25. Some are telling it's junk. Some are telling okay, error as void, cannot return a value. Okay, garbage. Somebody said 999. I don't know what is that. Okay. Okay. Error cannot assign void to variable. Okay. True. It's a void function, it won't return anything. All right. 25. Okay. So this program doesn't look valid. What is the reason it doesn't look valid? Because this function, this program returns this, so the first square function does not return any value. And the return type is declared as void, right? So here there is a mistake in the code itself. The square function is passing an argument a. It's not returning any value, but still we are trying to store a value. Okay, so it's a buggy program, in fact. So it doesn't make sense to write such programs. So let me modify it for now. Okay. So the program was not correct because square function does not return any value and we cannot store the return value of square as such. What do you think will be the output now? I modified the code. Can you tell me what is the output now? Okay, I'm getting most of the answers as 5. Okay, any other answer? Error undeclared variable result. A result I've removed actually, you can check. Yeah, so I got the answer as 5 here, so which is correct. Let's confirm this. Let me do a compile and run. Say GCC pass by value, gives a warning here. The reason for the warning is that I didn't add okay, by the way, I did not include the header file stdio.h. is it mandatory or optional to include the header file? Will the program compile if we don't include header file? Will that be an issue? You can give an answer as mandatory or optional. So many are telling yes, it's compiled. Ashwin is telling it's optional. Okay. Sohan, Pramod, Pyle is telling it's optional. Mandatory since standard library functions are used in code here. Okay, optional only for stdio. Okay. So let's, okay, PU says it will give warning at compile time. So it's optional. All right, no problem. So if you look at the code compilation using GCC, so you can see we are getting warnings here. It says implicit declaration of function printf, right? Incompatible implicit declaration of function printf. No, note, it should include stdio.h. But if you look at the compilation status, it gives a warning. It does not give any error. And if I do an ls, the a dot exe file is generated here. So please understand, I'm using Windows here, and I have installed GCC on Windows. There is a tool available called as MinGW. You can download it or install it on Windows also. And I have also installed a tool called as JitBash. So I'm using Windows. I'm not using Linux. That's the reason it generates a.exe. It's not generating a.out. All right. So please understand that we will not see a.out on Windows. We'll see a.exe on Windows. So let me run this code. Let's see if it runs. Okay. It gives the output as 5. Hope the screen is visible. Okay. Now, what is the reason the header file is optional? Header file is optional because, let me, even though it works, it's not a good way to do that. You cannot ignore the warnings. Is my voice audible? Rani says voice is breaking. Am I audible? Okay, voice is okay, they say. So generally, if there is a voice issue, it will show to me that there is a voice issue. But typically, if you're not able to hear, then it's a network problem at your side. If I get a network problem, I typically get a pop-up here telling that it's not audible. So I'll continue. So can you tell me why did the program compile and run also? Where are functions defined? Are functions defined inside header file or somewhere else? Can somebody answer? Where are functions defined? Where is printf function defined? Is it defined inside header file or not? Okay, some are telling it's defined inside stdio.h. I'm getting answers. Okay, it's in lib module, it's in header file, lib.so. Header file contains function prototype. Okay. Header file contains function prototypes, libc.so. Good. Okay. So please understand one thing here. So when you talk about a function declaration versus function definition, okay. So you need to understand that when you talk about any function, so when you talk about any function, let's say you have a function, then function prototype typically, right? So you have a prototype and you have the definition. So function prototypes are declared inside header file. And function definition, when you write code, goes to the source file, so which is .c file. So header file is nothing but .h. So this is a standard practice which we need to follow, unless you are creating a program with only .c. So typically, when you work on larger projects, you will have multiple .c files. and you'll also have multiple .h files. So .h files contain function prototype, .c file contains function definitions. So when you talk about built-in functions, let's say you talk about built-in functions, you can look out built-in functions. You will not see the source code, but you will only see the header files, right? So what is the reason? We don't see .c files anywhere in your system. Sorry, it's not audible. Okay, somebody interrupted. So .h file are stored in a path called as user include Linux. Right? For example, user include. Yeah. Who is this? So .h file is. So .h file is stored inside user include directory. For example, stdio.h is stored inside user include stdio.h. Right? Whereas source code. Sorry. Okay, I hope it's audible. Somebody's interrupting. So source file is not directly stored in your system. Instead, a compiled version of the source code is available. So when you talk about source code compilation, source code typically gets compiled to .o, and you may have multiple .o files all combined together into a library file. So library files will have extension .so. So you'll never see a .c file on your machine which contains the function definition for built-in functions. You'll always see .so files which contain the function definition. So example of a library is libc.so, right? And you also have libraries like libm.so. All right. So libc.so, can somebody tell me what does it contain? It contains the function definition for standard IO functions like printf, scanf. It also contains string related functions like string copy, string length. It also contains some of the very commonly used functions in C. So libc is a library which is installed by default on your machine, and functions like printf, when you call it from your C program, is actually invoked from the library file libc.so. So libm.so, can you tell me what is libm.so? What does it contain? Which function does it contain? Yeah, it contains math functions, right? For example, there are functions like sqrt, pow, etc. Right, so these functions like math functions, you'll see math functions like sqrt, right, pow. So these functions, which are mathematical functions, are defined inside libm.s. Now can you tell me where are these functions declared? So functions are defined here. Where are they declared? So yeah, it's declared inside math.h. So I'm getting many answers. So that's true. Okay. So header file only contains the function prototype, and definitions are stored inside library files. but the source code for library files are not available on your machine by default. Okay, but you can install the source code. For example, somebody is interested to look into the source code of printf, right? You have an assignment to implement a function called as printf. Let's say you're interested to see how printf is actually defined, or let's say you want to see how the function strcpy is implemented. So can we get the source code for these functions? Is it possible? Do you have any idea? Tapan says no. No. Okay. No idea. All right. No. Okay. Not yet. Okay. Not possible. Refer man page. I'm talking about source code, not the function prototype. Yes, header file, it's there, right? Yes, possible. Ganesh says it's possible as it's open source. Okay, that's good answer. So as we know, Linux is open source. Most of the applications and libraries which are available on Linux is also open source. If you want to install the source code for these libraries, it's possible. So there is a command to install the source code, and use the apt source command to install the source code for any application. Let's say you're interested to see, okay, the code for VI editor, right? You can always install the source code for the VI editor and see, you can have a look. So let's not worry about it right now. I just gave you some additional information. So please be aware that as a programmer, you can always open the header file and look at the function prototypes, but you will never see the source code for those built-in functions, because source code is not available in a in the text format. Source code is compiled and a library is given to the program. So next question I have is, let's say I've written a program. All right, let's say I write a program, a new program, when they power rusty. I include the header file stdio.h and I also include math.h. Can everybody pause? Sorry, mute. I'm just writing a program to find the power of a number. Okay. So let me compile this. If you don't know the prototype of a function, what we typically do, that we can do. How do you find the prototype? Let's say you're calling the function for the first time and you don't know how many parameters it takes or what type of parameter it takes. How do you know how to call it? Yeah, you can refer the man page, right? So man pages. So in regards to man page, I have one question. You will come across two types of functions in C, right? Those who have completed maybe LI module will know this. There is something called as library function, there is something called a system call, right? So which section of the man page contains library function? Which section of the man page contains system call? So where are man pages for library function stored and system calls? Okay, so I'm getting answers. Man 2 for system, 2 function call, man 3 library, 1 library. Okay, system call 2, library 1, system calls 2, 3 library, Ganesh says. Okay, man 3 library, Rani, Sujit, man 2 system, Narendra, man 2 system call, man 3 library. Okay. Some of you may not be aware of this if you're at the beginning of the C programming class. So typically, if you look at man, right, man is divided into many sections. So man page is divided into different sections. So section, man page sections, when you talk about, so you can see 1, 2, 3 and so on. So section 1, can somebody tell me what does it contain? What does section 1 contain? So it contains the man pages for commands. All right. Yes, Asha, you're right. Yeah, Sagar, shell commands. Section 2 contains the man pages for system calls. So what are system calls? Maybe those who are done LI will know what is system calls. These are nothing but functions which are exported by the Linux kernel. So more on this maybe you'll learn later when you talk, when you learn about system Linux internals. Yeah, examples of system calls. For example, you have system calls like read, you have system calls like write, etc. System calls like for, true, exec, yeah, right, dupe. Fine. Then we have library calls, right? Library functions or library calls, we call it. So library functions are defined inside section 3 of the man page, right? So let me show an example why you need to know this. So let's say I am doing a man on the function printf. Here man is not installed, no problem. Typically, let's say I don't have man installed. Man, when you do man, let's say on a function like printf, right? Let's say you do man on a function called as printf. Will it display the man page for the function printf, or will it show something else? Have you tried this? Does it display the man page for printf function, or it shows some other information? Karthik says yes, it shows all information. Okay, yes, it will display, shows print of all info, also shows S printf, VS printf, etc. Okay, are you sure? Does it show the man page for printf? Tapan says no, you have to pass 3, then it shows the printf man page. Ganesh says by default open section 3 of particular function. So Tapan, your answer is right. So when you see, use man printf, right, it's going to show the man page for printf command. All right, so you'll be wondering what this printf command is. In shell scripting also, in bash, there is a command called as printf. It's similar to the echo command, right? You might have used the echo command in shell. So there is also a printf command in the bash shell. So when you try to open the man page for printf function, it will show the man page for printf command. So this is what we need to learn here. So by default, it will open the man page based upon the order of sections. So you can see here, first section is command section. So it'll check whether there is any command called as printf. If the command is found, it'll display the man page for the command printf instead of function printf. Now, how do you open the man page for function printf? Yes, Pavani says it's man 3 printf. Kavya says man 3 printf. That's true. So we need to specify the section, right? So we can specify the section like this, man 3 printf, right? That's a correct way. So 3 represents the section number for library functions, right? That's true. So for example, if you want to look up the man page for, let's say, a system call, you can do man, let's say, 2, right? Read. You can do this. So if you don't specify 2, what will happen? Can somebody tell me? Let's say I don't specify this 2 here. What man page will it show for read? Will it show the read system call? Yes, Sujit says it'll show the command, right? So this read is actually available in 2 man pages, section 1 as a command, which is used to read variables in shell, section 2 as a system call. It's good to know these things in general. So let me switch back. So please be aware that specify the section number for functions if there is a conflict with. If there is no conflict, you don't have to worry about it. Now here I wrote this program, power.c. Did it compile this code? Let me compile it. What do you think? If I compile using this command gcc power.c, will it compile or not? I have included math.h. Will it compile? Okay, will it compile with warning? Okay, some are telling pass minus lm option, you'll get linker error, we should link it. It will not compile, but I included math.h, right? Is there any problem? Link error with warning, it will. Okay, let's try. Okay, let's see what happens.
Can you
show it? Did compile, right? Now okay, what we learned doesn't look proper, right? It's compiling actually. Power function doesn't accept variable arguments. Is that true? How many arguments does it? Let's run it. A.exe. It's printing a value, right? 97 point something it prints. I'll do some modification here. Okay, let me do a change. Printf. Enter the number. A small modification here. So I'm reading the value of number from user. I'm not hard coded it. Okay, I'm going to recompile this code. Still it's compiling. Sorry, there was a mistake in printer. What's wrong in the program? Let me put a slash in here. Okay, format specify for double. Printing with percentage F. Float. We didn't start basics of C. Shall we attend this session? Those who not attended C, new to C, need not attend this session. All right, it's not necessary. Somebody is doing Linux systems. It will be difficult for them to understand. No, the issue is that it's not displaying the printf message. Why is it not displaying the printf message? Okay, now it's working fine. Maybe I compiled the wrong program, that's the reason. So scanf, does it require a percentage LF or F? F is enough. Only F is enough. LF is required. Okay. What about printf?
F is enough. F is enough.
Okay. So I'm getting multiple answers. Some are telling F is enough. Some are telling LF is required. So in case of scanf for double, I think we need LF. Whereas for printf, we can use what? printf, that is good enough. We don't need a lf in case of printf. There is some issue with the output. I'm not sure because I installed GCC right now. Let me, I will come back to this program later. But typically, when you use a function like power or sqrt, right? So they are defined inside library libm.s, and to link to this library we have to use a flag called as minus lm, right? So you have to say gcc minus lm and the program name. For example, the program name in this case, in our case, will be pow.c. So when you use this flag is called the linker flag, right? So it's called the linker flag. So you need to instruct GCC to link to the MAT library. Let's say you have a file by the name, lib xyz.so. So how do you link to this library? Which flag should we pass? I'm getting answers. Minus LXYZ from Tapan, Saida, Sachin. Okay. So that's true. Narendra also says minus LXYZ. True. True. Minus XYZ or minus LXYZ. Sujit says minus XYZ. So the answer is minus L XYZ, right? So whenever you want to link to a external library, we need to pass the option minus L. Along with minus L, you have to specify the library name which we need to link to. So please understand, the file name is of the format libxyz.s. So when you pass the library flag to the linker, you need to only specify the name xyz without the prefix lib and without the extension .so. All right, so this is something which you need to aware of. So you can say gcc minus l xyz and the file name file.c. that's what we need to do. So what is the full form of .so here? What does SO stand for? Shared object. Gautam says it's shared object. Okay. What is it also called as apart from shared object? Does it have any other name? Okay, dynamic library, Gautam says. Dynamic library. So shared objects are also called as shared libraries. Okay, so in general, when you talk about libraries, so libraries are of two types. One is shared library, another is static library, right? So shared libraries in Linux have extension .so on Linux. Static libraries have an extension .a. Majority of the times when you link to a library, you're linking to the shared library. Static libraries are not commonly used to as a public library. You can have static libraries in your project in general. So shared libraries on Linux have extension.so. For example, on Windows it has extension.dll, right? You might have come across the extension.dll on Windows. So .so's are called as shared objects or shared libraries. One second. Okay, so let me switch to the next program here. So we discussed this pass by value right here. The question was what is the output for this program, right? So you answered, I gave the answer as 5. Majority of them gave the answer as 5. Some gave the answer as 25, which is not correct. So how does this work? So when you call the function, right here we have function square, and when you define a function, so when you define the function square, right, what is going to happen? So this function square, typically when you call a function in C, a stack gets created. We know this, right? So square is a function, and whenever a function is called, a stack frame gets created for the function square. Similarly for main also there is a stack, right? Main is also a function. So what all things are pushed to the stack? What all gets stored inside the stack? So we have local variables, we also have parameters and return address pushed to the stack. So in case of main function, we have a variable A whose value is 5, that's pushed to the stack. So when you call the function square, right, we're calling the function square here. So when you call the function square of A, what is the value of A here? 5, right? 5 is passed to the function square, and inside the function square, a variable num gets created, which again a local variable. So num will also be assigned to a value of 5. So typically when you call a function, the assignment operation happens, right? So the operation looks something like this: num is equal to A. This is the effect of invoking a function call. So square of 5 or square of A, when you call inside the function square, a variable num gets created, and num is assigned with the value of A. So this variable num and this variable A are two different variables stored in two different memory locations. We all know this. So when you modify num, A is not getting modified, right? A remains same. A is 5. That's what is passed by reference. Now, so let me explain what is passed by value. We all know this, but we are just refreshing before we get into more complex topics here. So let me convert this program to a pass by reference.c. Right. So how do you make sure that the value of A changes? inside square, what should we do? So we need to ensure that we pass the address of the variable A, right? So we need to pass address of the variable A. So here we need to pass address of A, correct? What is the change we need to do here? Num, right? Basically num is not a number, it should be a pointer. We call it as num pointer. Will this work? Will the value of A be 25 now? No, I'm getting answers no. I'm just checking whether you're paying attention or not. No, no, some are telling no. No. So what should be the corrections? We are not dereferencing, right? So it should be num pointer. That's true. So code should be star of num pointer. Should be star, right? Should be star. Okay, so if in case of readability, we can always put a parenthesis so that the program becomes more readable. All right. So this is a simple example of what is passed by reference here. So when you say pass by reference, for example, this code, let me erase this. We are almost at the 12 o'clock mark. I know that. Maybe I'll complete this, then we will stop the session. All right, so in case of this program, we also have a stack for main, right? We have main, and inside main we are having a variable A with a value 5. Let's assume the address of A is 100. Similarly, we'll have a stack for function square. And we have a variable called as num point. So what gets stored inside num point? So when you call the function, hundred, right? So address gets stored. So here you can see we are calling the function square of A. Address of A is what? 1000. That's ampersand of A. So num pointer will be assigned to the value of address of A, which is 100, right? So what does it indicate? So this variable num pointer is pointing to this location. So what is star of num pointer? You see here, star of num pointer. So num pointer is 100. What is star of num pointer? So star of num pointer is nothing but star of 100, right? Or value at the location 100. So what is the value at the location 100? It is nothing but 5. So this, in fact, right, when you typically expand this, star of num pointer is in fact equivalent to the variable A, as if we are doing A into A. A is equal to A into A. That's what is happening, right? Here, when you say star of num pointer, it's a R value, right? What does R value mean here? It's a right hand value. It's not a location value. So A into A, when you say value of A is multiplied by value of A, and the result gets stored back inside the location of A. So this will get replaced by the value 25, right? So we'll get the value as 25. So in general, when you talk about pass by reference, when you call the function, address of the function needs to be passed. And when you define the function, the parameter should be defined as a pointer type. So that's how we can define a function to use passby reference. So what is the reason we need to use passby reference instead of passby value? When will we use passby value, passby value, and we'll use passby reference? What are the scenarios? Yeah, arrays, for arrays we can use passby reference. Okay, any other reason use passby reference? Then the function returns more than two values, we can use passby reference. That's also true. Okay, for structures, for example, okay, structures, can we use passby value also? In fact, for structures we can do both. We can use passby value, we can use passby reference also. File says less time complexity. Is it less time complexity or space complexity? Okay, so space complexity, Tapan says file, sorry, space. Okay, space complexity. Okay, so maybe I'll just brief here on when typically we use passby value and when we use passby reference. So pretty much when you talk about a function, right, let's talk about a function, any function, let's see, right? So function, let's talk about program here, right? Let's say you are writing a program, right? So what is the definition of a program? What does the program do? So at a very high level, when you talk about a program, program takes input, right? It takes some input or inputs, I can say, and gives you some output or outputs, you can say. A function is also similar, right? If you look at a function, it's a smaller unit within a program, right? You can build multiple functions to build a program. So I can see people are leaving. Maybe I will stop the session here for today. Maybe we'll continue tomorrow. But what I would like to do is, maybe I would like to extend the session in general for the remaining days. I can see that 1 hour is not good enough to cover a good amount of topics. So will it be okay if I conduct this session for maybe 1.5 hours? Is that okay? So because to explain some of the concept takes more time, and you also provide your inputs. I don't mind extending it to more.
Yes, sir.
Some material, yes, sir. 2 hours also we can take, no problem. I don't have any issue. 11 to 1, 2 hours is okay. Start early, yeah, that's better. 2 hours is okay. So can I have it something like 10:30 to 12:30? Is that okay for you? Or 10:30 to 11? Let's say 1.5 hours. Somebody has any problem?
11 to 1.
Multiple suggestions.
11 to 1.
11 to 1. 10:30 to 12:30. Only 1 o'clock. It will be very late.
10:30 to.
10:30 to 12:30. It's good actually, good time.
Okay. Nasruddin says 10 to 2, 12.
take from
By the way, I have
to...
some question. Anyway, you don't have any much work to do. I hope you can get up early and basically attend the session early also, right? You're not going anywhere. All quarantined at home.
10:30 to 12:30 is okay.
Okay. We wake up late.
You can keep the session
11 to 1.
Somebody
11
says.
To 1. 11 to 1.
11
to
1.
10 to 12 is a good time, sir.
12.
Morning time is good, sir.
Take a median approach. I'll start
11.
At 10:30.
11 to 1. 11 to 1.
Who's that? 11
to
1. 11 is a little late now.
Yes, yes. Morning time is good, sir.
I know that. I'm also suggesting morning.
Because we're 12:30, we'll go for a lunch, no? So better to come 10:30 to 12:30. After that, you can take half an hour break also.
Sir, as you take decision, we can do.
Yeah, I'll take a decision now. I'll make it as 10:30.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir. It's fine for all.
10:30 to 12:30. I'll keep the session.
Okay.
So that I can cover more topics, because 1 hour it's difficult to cover topics here. Other thing is that I'm also getting used to these tools. There are a lot of tools I'm using, so switching between these tools will it's taking time. But once I get used to it, it will be okay. So I recorded the session. So we'll continue with this topic. So what I am doing is that I'm starting with a topic, and I am actually diversifying to some other topics which are related.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And one more thing, I just want to post a message in the group. Today there is no quiz. Maybe tomorrow onwards we'll start the quiz section. Whoever attended the session yesterday, the quiz will be announced at 6 p.m. on our Instagram channel. Okay. Emerge the IT. We can. We can look for the results at Emerge the IT Instagram channel. We'll send a mail and group also. You can check that. So thank you, everybody. Thank you for attending the session. Tomorrow maybe we will continue with the session. We'll also have some quiz session. Tomorrow's timing will be 10:30 to 12:30. I'll also share the question set in the group. No issues. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Send it to Google Groups or WhatsApp.
Yeah.